In Brussel wonen 1 miljoen mensen. Hier in Londen hebben er maar liefst 8 miljoen. Veel volk leidt tot veel kruisbestuivingen en dus veel creativiteit. Heel veel impulsen. Vandaar neem ik je vandaag mee naar het enige echte, hippe Londen.
Wat zeggen namen als Banksy of Shepherd Fairey jou? Tot voor kort mij ook niks. In 2005 al kenden ze hier de boom van een nieuwe kunstvorm, street art.
Just up here we've got an old piece by Banksy. It's an Apache gunship with a little pink bow on its head, and it says, "Have a nice day."
Banksy, that's like the street artist among street artists. He's
yeah,
like the...
this guy is pretty much the most famous street artist, you know, out there, really. This piece is pretty old now. Once upon a time, Banksy had lots and lots of pieces all around. Not the case anymore. So the only Banksys that survive around here are under perspex, generally. Yeah. Banksy's, you know, one of the darlings of the art market now. His stuff goes for hundreds of thousands of pounds, if not millions. And it's not uncommon for people to try and remove entire Banksy walls.
Really?
Where's my money?
Here's a guy called Amigo. Then we've got Revert. So there's been a really nice piece that you guys in Belgium might be interested in. Is this one here by a guy called Roa, originally from Ghent.
He's from Ghent?
Yeah, yes. In the last 2 years, Roa's really emerged as a kind of massive name on the street art scene. Yeah. He's all over the world. You know, he's doing huge pieces in places like, you know, London, Berlin, the Gambia in Africa, all over America.
But it's always these animals that he does, right?
Yeah,
these
generally, yeah.
Black and white pieces with...
Yeah, and normally kind of maybe matching the city or the country that they're in. So in London, we get a lot of squirrels and foxes. In Gambia, where he did a big project recently, he was doing kind of zebras, monkeys, giraffes, all these kind of things. Okay, so here's a piece that you might not normally spot.
All right.
Yeah, so it's a guy called Pablo Delgado, Mexican guy.
So it's a very international scene then?
Sure, sure. You know, Stinkfish, guy from Colombia, was recently here doing some cool things. And you've got guys from New York, Chicago, kind of LA.
Then all mingling together right here because of the art.
Exactly.
Voor street artists is de wereld hun canvas, na 7 jaar uitgegroeid tot big business.
The whole nature of street art is changing. It started with breaking the law, and now each time I do a piece, it's like changing the law a little bit more. So I've seen street art go through different phases of legality, and this is the kind of, I feel, yeah, kind of privileged now. It's nice. You can just take it easy and just go, oh yeah, just doing a bit of painting, it's all right. So yeah, everyone's a bit chilled about it now. So the street, you can work with the surface here. I've got a really lovely natural framework to work with here. It's in a street, it's life-size, people interact with it. People stand here and like and pose for photographs in front of you. You don't get any of that in a gallery.
That's true. Thank you so much, Mr.
Thank
Stick.
Thank you very much.
For colouring the cities of London.
And I'd like to come to your country and paint over there.
Hey, man, you're
really
welcome.
Nice.
Thank you so much.
Sweet.
Bye-bye.
Nice one. Thank you.
Het snel kloppende hart van Londen heeft nog een belangrijke trend voortgebracht. Voor ik het weet, bevind ik me in een andere wereld. In het land van de homo hipsternicus.
De homo hipsternicus, of kortweg hipster, voelt zich nog het meest in zijn sas wanneer hij kan luisteren naar zijn independent music, nippen van zijn café latte of kan flaneren in zijn flanellen hemd. Het is een soort van bourgeois bohemien. Je vindt ze in de wijken Dalston, Hackney, Shoreditch. Deze mensen zijn niet cool, ze zijn gewoon ubercool. Looking in the mirror, looking back, a look of wild living, bound to crack. Ik neem vandaag de East London Line, sinds kort omgedoopt tot de Hipster Express, omdat deze overground je nu eenmaal recht naar het hart van het hipster district brengt.
This is where the magic happens.
The next station is Dalston Kingsland.
I wanted to introduce you to Tina We Salute You because it's one of the most exciting future-led places in Dalston right now.
So what I see right here...
It's not only a cafe, it's actually a very great cafe, but it's more about the art and how they go on about showcasing the artwork.
So the stuff I see on the walls right now, that's actually art hanging up. That's
yes.
An artist who made
it. Yeah, it's their current show and it's by a local artist called Benjamin Murphy. Benjamin is finishing his master's, and that's the great thing about Tina. All the art goes directly onto the walls, so nothing is ever hung. And Tina, we salute you. Have a show, a new show every 8 weeks.
Really?
Yeah.
So every work changes every eight weeks.
Yes.
Wow, that's incredible. Me go shopping, ben a falla, me go shopping, eh. Ben me go shopping with you.
Bedegonden. Me go shopping with you. Ben, Dalston is a really old neighborhood. It dates back to the 17th century. This area is very warehouse-based, factory buildings, because all of the goods used to come into East London, because we're so close to the docks. And then when that stopped, this whole area shut down. And most buildings lay, you know, stood empty for between 20 to 30 years.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, 10 years ago, for example, certain areas didn't have street lighting.
Really?
Yes, where we're walking right now was completely derelict. It would have been a very dark place to be. Most people wouldn't have come here. Mm-hmm. But then there was potential, and creative people who moved to the area 10 years ago started to see the potential in all these buildings. And started to change the use of them.
So now you have all these artists coming together here, right here in Dalston.
Absolutely. Then, if you want to find out about the hippest, the newest, the most exciting fashion destination in London, it's here, LNCC.
It doesn't look like a very fashionable place.
It is, Ben. You'll have to wait and see. We'll have to ring the bell for us to let us in.
To
come to LNCC by appointment only.
Really?
Yes. Most of the business.
Hey guys.
Hello.
I'm down, yeah?
Thank you.
Zeer speciaal. Oh, thank you. Doors open. All right. Well, I must say, May, very remarkable place. It makes me think of Starship Enterprise or something like that.
Yes, Ben. I really like LNCC. This is their fashion concept store in London. They have 7 rooms showcasing international fashion mixed with the hottest, the youngest, and the most talented Japanese designers of the moment. The whole idea of having the different rooms is to give you different feels about the space.
Okay.
So over here we have the organic room. The fashion that's exhibited in here has that rawness to it.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have the library. And they have a club space.
So they even have club evenings. So they go for the whole experience, that's what I get.
Absolutely, that's what they want to give their clientele.
But what's the deal with the appointment? Why do you have to have an appointment if you want to come in?
Well, the idea is to give their customer an intimate experience in an environment where they can actually enjoy shopping in a relaxed atmosphere.
So it's a very personal approach then?
Absolutely.
Okay, well, May, thanks a lot for making that appointment. Je hoort het, als je naar LNCC wil komen, zorg ervoor dat je vooraf een afspraak maakt.
May wil de dag afsluiten met een hoogtepunt, het meest romantische uitzicht over de stad.
We're just going to go to the roof of this building. This is a disused car park, as you can see. At the top is a pop-up art project, specifically sculpture, and it's called Bold Tendencies.
Hold back the night from us. Cherish. cherish the life for us. Don't let the shadows hold back the dawn.
I must say the view up here is incredible.
Cold city lights glowing, the traffic of life is flowing.
Thanks so much for an extraordinary day, and I get the impression that in London everything changes so easily. How, as a foreigner, can I keep up?
There are certain publications where it promotes the hip and what's happening in London, such as Time Out. They are also online, and they list all of the things that are happening in the moment.
All right, so an incredible spot with an incredible view. Let's inhale the moment then.
Ik kan er niet omheen dat de snelle hartslag van deze stad zo stilaan het leven uit mijn lijf zuigt. Dus de nacht is wel gekomen.
Hold back the night.
De volgende ochtend is het alweer zover. Ik trek naar Hackney en maak me klaar voor de hipsterparade op zaterdag.
Vijf jaar terug was Hackney nog een van de meest verloederde buurten van Londen. Maar vandaag is het wel eventjes anders, want je vindt hier de enige echte hipster in alle geuren en kleuren. En waar gaan ze naartoe om even uit te rusten? Dat doen ze hier in het London Fields Park. Kleren kopen ze op de nabijgelegen Vintage Market. En om te eten gaan ze naar Broadway Market. Nu, verwacht hier geen hotdogs of hamburgerkramen. Nee, hier heb je wereldkeuken, maar ook andere dingen, zoals paling in gelei, niet echt mijn ding, en cupcakes.
Chocolate cupcakes, vanilla cupcakes, banana walnut cupcakes will stick to your buttocks cupcakes. Zelfs de nieuwe whoopie pie. Enfin, alle soorten, ik ben fan. Zaterdag is de hoogmis voor mensen die mee willen zijn. Niet alleen omdat er in Londen verschillende hipstermarkten zijn, zoals Spitalfields en Columbia Road, maar vooral omdat iedereen wil gezien worden en dat tot een gratis modeshow leidt. Nog zo'n opvallende trend zijn de fietsen in de meest opvallende kleuren. Al noemen de hippe mensen dit geen fiets, maar een fictie.
So Danny, this is the next best thing in London. Why would you call this a fixie?
Fixie are single-speed bikes. They only have one gear, so they make them a lot easier to maintain, less things to go wrong. In a place like London, there's not too many hills, so the fact that they're single-speed, they're actually mechanically a lot more efficient. Mm-hmm. Very light as well.
Yeah.
I can do the little finger test. There you go.
So that's what it's all about. Where did this come from? I mean, who came up with the idea of driving fixies through the city?
I think it started in San Francisco, the couriers. They were looking at bikes which were a lot more reliable than standard bikes. They were a lot quicker as well. And, what they would do is take old frames and do them up. And that's how it started, really.
This is very hip in London if you ride a fix. So why is it not as if it's an innovation?
Yeah, people are deciding what clothes to wear. You know, obviously clothes keep you warm, but at the same time it's an expression of who you are. And the same applies these days with custom-made bikes, which obviously is what we offer.
You make these custom, so every bike's different.
Then. Yeah, on the website there's a little app, which is quite a bit of fun, where you can literally pick your colour frame, types of handlebars, colour tyres, colour chains, and you know, get carried away, really.
Okay. So when visiting London, I do get to try these out.
That's right. We offer this rent-a-fix scheme, so people can come down and rent one of the bikes for an hour, a day, a week, if you happen to be in the area. And then what we do, if you then decide to buy, there's no obligation whatsoever, if you do decide to buy one, we refund the rental fee.
Really? I'm going to try one out then.
Okay, that's great.
Een fixed gear bike onder de kont en ik ben onderweg richting City of London. Want ik wil het hebben over de vreemde gebouwen die Londen rijk is. Ze kregen allemaal een naam. De Shard, de Scherf dus, de Gherkin, oftewel de Augurk. De skyline van Londen is voortdurend in beweging.
So Hadley, this is the financial centre in London, so this is probably the reason why you do get all these fancy new buildings over here.
Well, this is the Lloyds building. It's one of Roger's greatest creations, and it is purely one of those moments of almost wonderful architectural madness. Basically, what he did was turn a building inside out.
Might I say that I don't like this one very much?
Some people hate it, some people love it. One of the people that hates it is Sir Norman Foster.
Right.
Hence, we actually have one of his, the Willis Building, next to it, which has this wonderful curved front, which is a reflecting mirror, effectively. I'm pretty much saying, in your face, Rogers, in my opinion. There are rumours of them having a deep-rooted hatred, which is one of the best things that could have ever happened to British modern architecture.
Why is that?
Well, it makes them compete to be more environmentally friendly, more challenging with their designs, more creative with their architecture.
Right. So this one I know. This is the Gherkin.
It's actually 30 St Mary's Axe.
Oh.
The Gherkin is a nickname,
yeah,
which, amongst others, Sir Norman Foster's and partners are involved with this, and they hate. Personally, I think they're lucky that most Londoners like it, otherwise the nickname would be a lot ruder.
Yes, I've heard the erotic stroking penis and stuff like that.
Oh, you get all sorts. The septic dildo is one of the other ones that comes up.
OK, so what's the idea? It's a complete oval thingy or round?
Well, it's designed basically as a circular cross-section to cut down wind resistance, as a result of which this uses a third of the materials you'd normally use to build a building the same size. You don't need as much of a frame to make it rigid to stop it shaking. It's the first purpose-built, environmentally friendly office. However, there was a bit of a mistake when they built this.
What was that one?
Well, somebody, without consulting the architects, changed the glass. The glass was meant to be bulletproof, which is about
five centimetres
thick, to bombproof, which is triple the thickness, triple the weight. As a result, this started to fall over.
OK.
So they had to pump it back up by pumping compressed liquid cement underneath the foundation to push it back upright. To this day, if you go to the restaurant on the 27th floor, it looks like London's falling over, because it's still 5 degrees off true.
You've got your own Tower of Pisa. This is like a suicide.
This is the Barbican, and it's a product of 1950s, sort of very much American influence, utopian architecture.
All right.
It took until 1984 for them to finish it, at which point it was the most hated piece of architecture in Europe.
All right.
It's now one of the most sought-after places to live, and the beautiful reason is inside, and the beauty is we get to go in and see it.
Let's go and see it.
The Barbican is basically, it's a city within a city. It's designed to be a small town. It was designed so you could be born here, grow up here, educated here, even perhaps work here, be it in the shops, the cafes, the bars, the schools.
All right.
This is the high street. But how many high streets do you know where you have carpet and free Wi-Fi? This is a remarkable place, and out here is the reason why.
Wow. Just as you said, city within a city, yeah.
Yeah, and it's built in bomb craters. This was an area that was destroyed during the Second World War. It was almost a natural inclination to take something that was destroyed, that was wrecked by war and horror, and turn it into homes and into a place that people wanted to live. And where the craters were is literally where these lakes are.
Okay.
And all round the edge of them is where the buildings, but also underneath us, in what was the craters, is the infrastructure for the buildings. So they didn't actually have to dig down. It was a bit of a cheat in certain respects.
So you get all these people in these small apartments, and they're willing to pay enormous amounts of money.
Well, some of it's social housing still.
How much would it cost?
It has to be at least 20%. There is slightly more here.
Yeah, but how much would it cost me to buy one of these apartments?
The average price to buy a property in London nowadays, anywhere, is £1 million. Here, you're looking higher.
This is one of the most sought-after places. You've got lots of artists, writers, filmmakers living here.
£1 million?
But part of that is you get private garden spaces. Every single house, maisonette and flat here has some form of garden space. And actually, the other thing you'll notice now, we've been here for a few moments, you can't hear a car.
Oh, yeah. We zitten dus echt wel in het hartje van Londen, maar traffic, no.
Maar La Pièce de Résistance moet nog komen. We rijden naar Stratford, naar de plek waarmee Londen de rest van de wereld een poepje wil laten ruiken. Het prachtige Olympic Park.
This is, of course, the Olympic site. Perhaps the most pivotal demonstration of, in some respects, the future of modern architecture in London.
Well, that's my favourite, right over there. I believe
that's, it was Hadid's.
Zaha Hadid, yeah, exactly.
This beautiful manta ray form in the middle is the permanent
structure.
Looks like
a wave, yeah.
Oh, yeah, it's a beautifully, beautifully, almost sculptural piece of architecture. The sides come off and they're recyclable. I'm hoping the seating will then go on to other arenas to be used. So the main arena will go to one of London's football clubs. There's various bids and competition for it at the moment. Yeah. The velodrome is staying, and also the area all around it will become a major cycling and cycling sports park for London. The basketball court, which is the white one in the background, that will actually be packed down, put on a ship, and go to the next Olympics. So you might end up with an Olympic almost circus big top set going around
the
world.
That would be interesting, yeah.
Could be quite an interesting challenge for modern architecture.
Brilliant.
Nog één afspraak rest me en dan trek ik me voortaan terug uit die hipsterwereld. Nog één afspraak in Shoreditch.
This is Shoreditch High Street.
Did you want to meet up here in this street?
Well, Whitecross Street is synonymous with street food, as you can see. And street food is such a massive thing nowadays. You know, it's one of those things that a lot of people haven't been able to afford to open up restaurants. So we've got really good chefs now opening up really good, you know, places where the average person can buy really good value food. I mean, there's Italian food, there's Spanish food, there's Brazilian food even. You've got burritos.
Very good. I'm really hungry by now.
Hungry.
I mean, what would you suggest? Where we go?
Well, the burrito stall has to be one of my favourites.
Going to the burrito stall. So yes. What type of burrito would you suggest?
Well, I'm going to go for some carnitas, because for me, that's one of the most traditional ways to cook meat in Mexico. So, and it's, carnitas is slow-cooked pork, where the pork's cooked in fat. But it's so delicious.
There goes my diet.
Hi there, how are you doing?
We would like to have two carnitas, if possible.
Oh! You searching round my brain.
Looking for a way to make it. Wow, this is very good. So right now, Gizzy, we're at Red Church Street.
Yes, we are. And Red Church Street is now, basically put it this way, in the Evening Standard, which is our big London newspaper, it was dubbed as the new Lower East Side of New York. It's got all of the cool places you want to be. It's got really cool boutiques. It's one of the main hubs of the design world. Most of the big creative companies are here. Got really cool restaurants like this. This is Boundary, a really swanky restaurant. And then actually, just around the corner, you've got Shoreditch House, which is where all the celebrities hang out.
Really?
Literally, if you want to be seen and be cool in London, you come here.
So this is where it's happening. This is where all the cool people are.
Yeah.
But where are they? There's nobody here.
I'm like, hi.
Oh, yeah. Sure. When I'm in London town, I like to shop around. See what if I had money, I could buy.
You know, designer scenes, serve all designer needs. So, one of my favourite shops in the whole of this area, actually one of my favourite shops in the universe, is this shop, Maison L'Aide Trois Garçons. And it's an interior shop, as you can see.
Yeah.
And basically, I mean, you can see it's a feast for your eyes. It's really exciting. All the furniture here, it's vintage. Well, it's run by three guys, who one of them is an interior designer and a really cool one. He's very, you know, hip around here. And actually, these guys were the first. And it'd be fair to say that they were innovators of this whole scene, you know. They took a total risk, putting a really good product in a random, fairly industrial area is quite a risk. So it's paid off in their case, but you know, that's brave.
Yeah.
And this mirror here, I've had my eye on for a while. What do you reckon?
Oh, let's have a closer look.
I know.
Looks interesting, Dale.
No, see, I'm scared now you're here. I'm actually gonna have to buy it.
Yeah, you have. What's the price? Does it have a price tag on it?
Oh. You don't wanna know.
Really? These goods piled so high to catch the eye. Attract me though I haven't got a beam. But that is okay, for I never pay. Just liberate them when nobody can see.
So, I'm going to show you something so cool that if you didn't know about it, you would never even know it existed.
Really?
Okay. You like jewellery?
Oh, yes, I'm really fond of jewellery. Look at the amount of rings I'm wearing right now.
You'll like this stuff, I promise you.
Okay. We're there.
Mm-hmm.
Ah.
Hello.
Hello. Hi.
Hey, gorgeous one.
How are you?
Good, thanks.
Hey, man.
How are you doing? Are you good?
Good, man. Yeah. Good. Ben, nice to meet you.
Ben, what do you reckon?
Well, I think it suits you very well, Gizzy, I must say. But to cook with that kind of ring must be kind of difficult.
Yeah, a little bit impractical, but I love it. I mean, you just got to look at the attention to detail in here. And that probably explains why he is sort of a leading light in what's happening in jewellery at the moment.
Really?
Well, very nice of her to say so. Yeah, I'd like to think so, possibly, yeah.
What would you say your style is?
Oh, good question. A lot of people say gothic, but I mean, generally just quite heavy, bold. I mean, you've got to be kind of brave to wear some of it. It's not particularly fine jewellery, as some people would say. Everything's hand carved, so it's quite sculptural. That's kind of my look.
Okay, this is a men's ring, I presume.
When I first met you, I think this was kind of one of the pieces that all of our friends were wearing.
Yeah,
like, this is,
so.
Would you say your signature piece?
Very much my signature piece. It's kind of. Friends see it on.
I'm gonna press it on. Let's try to get this off afterwards.
Look at that, perfect fit.
Perfect fit.
Who'd have known it?
Doesn't really suit you,
does
it?
Do you know what? As much as you're cool, not cool enough for this, I'm afraid.
Well, you know.
Schrijf Red Church Street op in je memoboek, want hoewel ze hier niet schreeuwen hoe hip ze wil zijn, vind ik hier het meest onontgonnen Londen terug.
So, the fantastic vintage shop we were at earlier, it's the sister of this fantastic restaurant. I mean, you can see the likeness, can't you?
Absolutely, yeah.
You can imagine, night falls, you can pretend you're in 1920s Paris.
Feeling it already, is he? So they got great food in a great decor. Best of both worlds.
Best of both worlds. You've got style, you've got the quality of food, and you know, it's been inspiring for me from the very beginning.
Now, Gizzy, must be really tiring being a hipster since you need to keep up with trends all the time.
Oh, it's exhausting. It's a tiring life. No, seriously, following trends, it tends to come organically. From my opinion, I would say to avoid all of the obvious places, step away from the centre of town and go and find the nooks and crannies, the back streets. And also find the areas which tend to be a bit poorer. I know that sounds bizarre, but, you know, poverty does breed creativity. And you tend to find in the areas like East London, South London, Peckham, definitely head out of the ordinary.
OK, so there you have it, the one and only advice by Gizzy herself. Get off the beaten track. That's
yes.
it. OK, I'll
Certainly.
Drink to that.
Cheers.
Cheers. Kind of feeling this, you know, Paris by night together with Gizzy here at the table. Uh-huh. So romantic. How are you feeling?
I'm getting hungry. Can we eat?
Het is meer dan alleen de looks. Er zit ook een filosofie achter. Alleen heb ik die nog niet echt kunnen achterhalen. Ik heb trouwens nog één fantastisch goede tip voor u. Als je naar Londen komt en je loopt een hipster tegen het lijf, noem ze dan vooral niet hipster. Because they simply don't feel comfortable with that term.
Dit was hem. Het zit er helemaal op. 4 weken lang de grote opleisting van de places to be in Londen. Rustig nalezen kan uiteraard op onze website 1.be/Vlaanderen Vakantieland.